something. We started last week with this great kumbaya meeting that we all gazed at, and the president got good and due credit for bringing people together in that room, getting them on television, and go make a deal. From then on, are you disappointed in what he's shown in terms of deal making? You know, he goes back on his promise 2 days later. Then he gets into it about the wall. Kelly goes out there, tries to move his position on the wall towards reasonable. He fights back in a tweet, says the wall hasn't changed. Then he says Chip shouldn't be in the CR, which is the only thing that the Democrats saw as a carrot in it. And the White House had to correct him. I mean, that just doesn't sound like savvy at work there.
Well, I disagree with that, of course. I think the president has a lot of experience negotiating, and he changes his positions frequently when he was building, you know, billion-dollar skyscrapers, and I think he'll do the same things here. At the end of all of this, though, we know that DACA really isn't important to the Democratic Party because they chose leaking an allegation that the president used some kind of, you know, expletive during intense negotiations. They chose leaking that and ruining negotiations over getting a deal for DACA. And Chris, here's what I think.
What about your boy Lindsey?
The president's
golf partner.
I get that, but Lindsey Graham doesn't represent the Republican Party. Oftentimes, he's
in agreement about,
now
Michael?
With the president.
How can you say that about Lindsey Graham?
I'm talking about Lindsey Graham being Lindsey Graham as a legendary, longtime critic of Donald Trump. They're friendly about
They've been golfing.
But he's always been critical. No doubt. And the president doesn't have a problem going golfing or sitting down with people that he disagrees with.
Look,
but Lindsey Graham doesn't represent
the president.
The
president said
Party
what we know he said, and he expressed a preference for immigrants from Norway over basically anywhere that has brown people. That's what he said. That's what he believes. It's consistent with like a half dozen other statements about immigrants.
But you can't.
That's who he is, Michael.
But you can't stand. That's not true. And you can't stand to step back and let the president solve this DACA problem. The fact of the matter is,
he left. He's going
golfing.
He's leaving to go to an anniversary party for himself today. Who does that?
Listen, the president is going to cut a DACA deal that even the Democrats can live with. And I believe he'll probably alienate some of his base with this DACA deal. The problem the Democrats have is they can't have the president in the lead on this issue. The president wants to give these DACA, these dreamers, something to hang on to.
Give me one indication that the president wants to do that. One, and then I'll let you go for the weekend.
Sure. First of all, he's told me that. He said it several times on the campaign trail.
When did he tell you that? When did he tell you my priority is saving these dreamers? I feel terrible about it. I want a bill of love. You've heard him say that.
He's told America that he wants that.
I know. He did tell them that.
And then during the campaign.
And then he rejected the deal that was the closest thing to a bill of love 2 days later.
Yeah, but the bill that came to him 2 days later was filled with deal breakers that the Democrats knew were deal
breakers.
It checked
every box he asked.
They were poison pills, Chris.
It had Lindsey Graham and other Republicans behind it from the Senate. It checked every box. Not completely, but that's called compromise.
Lindsey Graham. You keep going to Lindsey Graham. He's not an indication that there's widespread Republican support of anything, Chris.
And just to
he's
be
not.
Clear,
I mean, he's a legitimate voice in opposition. He's a legitimate critic of the president, but he doesn't represent the majority in Congress.
Most see him as an honest broker. When the president does the right thing, he's with him. When he doesn't, he's against him. Some would call that leadership. And remember, Mitch McConnell, the leader of the Republicans in the Senate, says he doesn't know what the president wants either. But Michael Caputo, you make the case, and you're always appreciated here to do so. Have a good weekend. Enjoy the anniversary.
Release the memo, Chris. Release the memo.
I was waiting for that. Tell me what's in it. You don't
what's
know.
What's in it? 4 pages. I don't know, but I want to release
I know.
So I can see it.
That's what I'm saying. I've never heard congressmen talk so much smack about something offering nothing what's in it. But when it comes out, we'll talk about it. I promise you that. Be well.
I'll be looking forward for that call.
Allison.
Sounded almost like you had the memo to release.
I have it right here.
I wish. Let's read that.
That would be a great show. I'm too tired to read it. I'd have to hand it over to you, and then I take a nap.
I'll do a dramatic reading. Meanwhile, as we all know, there have been so many women's issues that have come to the fore in this first year of the Trump presidency. So we wanted to know how female Trump